Hey, what's up guys? It's Yvonne, and in this video I want to show you how to track click-to-call conversions with Facebook ads. So basically phone call clicks. So whether you're on the phone or on the website, let's suppose here we have a phone number on the contact page. If somebody clicks on it, we want to track that click. So on the phone, they'll be prompted to actually make the call, and on the website here, we're prompted to pick an app to make the phone call. So that's what we want to track. So in order to do this, we need to A, have the Facebook pixel already set up and available, and to have Google Tag Manager. So I'm going to show you how to set both of these things up very quickly. It's very, very easy. And then we're going to proceed with the click-to-call conversion tracking. Let's get into it. So the first thing we need is the Facebook pixel. So if you guys don't already have a Facebook pixel in place, it's very easy to set up. Just find the business settings or settings in your Facebook ads account and come over here to data sources, click on data sets, and just create a new pixel. Click on add. And just enter a name and you'll be able to set up your pixel. What you will have to do as well is assign a person. So you would have to attach your own account to this pixel, and assets, you would have to attach your ad account to the pixel. And that's it, your pixel will be available. So let's imagine for this case, we want to use this simplest Facebook pixel just because I've created so many pixels, which unfortunately you can't delete. So let's imagine we created this simplest FB pixel. That's the name of the pixel, okay? So the second thing we have to do is set up Google Tag Manager, which will make the process so much easier. So if you guys don't already have a Google Tag Manager account, just head over to tagmanager.google.com and follow the steps. It will ask you a few questions, super easy to do. You will then get a prompt that looks something like this. So you just need to put this code on your website. You don't need to meddle with the Facebook pixel code, anything like that. The process is super simple. So in our case, we're using WordPress. So if you just install the plugin WP Code Lite, that's all you're gonna need. Then you will see this option on the left-hand side, code snippets, click here, click on header and footer, and simply add the Google Tag Manager code, this top part over here, and the bottom part in the body section, and just click on save changes. If you're not using WordPress, just add the code to the head and body section of your page. Whether it's ClickFunnels, Unbounce, they all give you options to add code to the page, so just go in and do that. And that should be it. Once you add the Google tag to the page, you can hit submit, you can save changes, and the Google Tag Manager will be installed on your website, and you are good to go with the initial setup. So now we're gonna go in here and actually set up the click-to-call conversion in Facebook ads. And by the way, if you don't see that prompt, if you exit it out by accident, if you just click right over here, it will show for you right here as well. So let's get started with the setup. So let's go back into our Facebook account and we're gonna go to Events Manager over here. And we're just gonna click on data sources here. And again, disregard all these pixels. Unfortunately, I can't delete them. Nobody can delete their pixels. I don't know why, that's still not doable. But this is our pixel in question, right? The simplest FB pixel. That's the one that we decided we're gonna use. So the only thing we need from here is this data set ID, this one right here, okay? So let's hop over back into Google Tag Manager and we're just gonna click on new right over here. We're gonna give this a name. So let's say Facebook ads. Click to call. That's what we're tracking here. We're going to click on tag configuration and you're going to look for the Facebook pixel. Now you might not see it here. If you scroll down, if you go into search and you type in Facebook, if you don't see it here, that's totally fine. We're just going to deselect that. Just click this option over here, community template gallery, and you'll be able to find it from here. It's going to be readily available for you to import into this tag type option. So you're going to search for Facebook here and grab the Facebook pixel right here. And this is gonna make the process so easy and simple for you, okay? And that's one of the reasons why I love Google Tag Manager. It simplifies the whole process. You don't have to deal with that complicated Facebook pixel stuff that they seem to make harder and harder every year for some reason. So you should see it here. You're just gonna click Facebook pixel and all you need is the Facebook ID. That's all you're gonna need from here. So let's come back over here. Let's grab our dataset ID here. Let's copy it. Let's come back here. We're gonna paste it and you're gonna give the name for this event. So it's not a page view, right? It's a call. So you could call it lead if you want. You could call it contact if you want, whatever makes more sense for you. If you already have a form and you already have these events for forms that you have on the page or other Facebook pixels that you've set up, you can click on custom and you can just give this a name. So you can name this, let's say, phone call click, for example. And that's all for this. Then we're going to scroll down. We're going to go to trigger. And now we need to add the trigger, right? So when do we want this tag to fire? Well, when somebody clicks on our phone call buttons, right? So I already have it here that we've set up, but if you don't, obviously, you can just click on plus, click on new trigger, give this a name. Let's say phone call click, click configure. And we're going to select just links over here. We're going to say some link clicks, right? We don't want every single click to be recorded, just the phone call clicks. We're going to select a variable. We're going to say click URL. You should see it here. If you don't see click URL, you can click on that little plus icon right there and you will see click URL right here. Okay. So click URL contains, we're going to say tell, okay? Because on a website, whenever you have tell in front of some numbers, that prompts the browser or the mobile phone to open up the app to call. So over here, you can see on the bottom left, it says tell double dots plus 1-800, right? And then when you click on it, that's the prompt that allows this pop-up to occur to say, hey, okay, so this is a phone call, okay? So over here, we're going to say, as long as the click URL contains this, we want to track it. We want to see how many people attempt to call us. If you have different phone numbers, then you can just enter the number that you want here. So in our case here, we have this number. We have this number. So if you have, for some reason, multiple numbers on your website and you want to track clicks on a specific number, then you would just enter that specific number here. In our case, we want to track all phone call clicks on our site. So we're going to leave it like this. We're going to click save. And that should be it. It's as simple as that. So now we're going to go in and test it both on the Google Tag Manager side and on the Facebook side as well. So let's go in here and click save. And let's test it first in Google Tag Manager. Then we're going to save and then we're going to test it in this test events here with Facebook to ensure that it actually properly gets sent through to Facebook. So let's come over here. Let's click preview. And we're going to enter our website URL, which is this. That's the contact page. We're going to click on connect. You should see a little pop-up here saying that the tag assistant is active. We're going to scroll down. Let's come back here for a second. Let's click on continue and let's take a quick preview of the tags that fire. Now, disregard all of these tags. These are tags set up from my course, from my other videos. So the main thing we're looking for is this tag that we've set up, right? Let's filter it by last edited. It's going to be this one, Facebook ads click to call. That's the name of the tag that we're looking for here. Okay. So if we don't see it here after we click on the tag, something is wrong. Something's not working. So let's come in here and let's actually click on this and see if that triggers. So the person won't necessarily actually make the phone call. It's just the click for now. That's the only thing we're tracking here. So let's click cancel. Let's go back and see if anything changed. And here it is, Facebook ads click to call. Okay, so that has been successfully tracked and set up in Google Tag Manager. So that's good news. So now we can go in here and let's just close out of this preview mode and let's save our changes and then go back and test all this in the Facebook Events Manager. So let's click submit. Let's give this a name. Let's say Facebook ads click to call tracking. For our reference later on, we're going to click on publish. And here is our latest change right here. Let's go back to workspace. Let's go back to tags. And that should be up and running. Okay, again, let's sort by last edited, Facebook ads. So now let's go back and enter this URL into the Facebook Events Manager. Let's go into test events here. And let's make sure that this event is in fact being fired. So we're going to select this option here. We're going to enter the website URL. We're going to click on test events. And now we can come back here and we can see what's going on. Okay, so in this case, we don't have any page view events set up here for this pixel, but I'm assuming you would. And the click to call is kind of the next step, right? It's tracking the specific clicks for the number. So let's go ahead and click on that and see if anything changes here with the Facebook pixel side. And we don't see anything show up here. However, we do see a little red warning here. And that's because we've set up a custom event, not a standard event that is already preset by Facebook. So we have to agree to their terms. So before the data actually shows up for our testing, we have to click on overview here. And it's going to say here, one custom event can't be used with the ads feature or a specific set of custom events. So we're going to click on review here and just read through the information. Click on learn more if you want to read more about it. Basically, they want to make sure you follow their terms and you're not setting up custom events that share personal information based on health, financial, consumer report, anything like that. So in our case, it's not. It's just a phone call click. We're going to click on I acknowledge. We're going to select this one here. We're going to click on next. We're going to click on confirm the custom event. Click on confirm again. And now that should be ready and available for us to use. So now let's go back and repeat the same thing, maybe even refresh the page so that little red warning goes away. And now let's go back here into test events. Let's click here. Let's enter our website URL again. Click on test events. And I'm assuming you already have some sort of page view events or anything like that. Those are pretty easy to set up. But if you don't, you won't see anything until the actual event that you've set up. So we're going to scroll down now. And right now we just see the page view. That's fine. So we're just going to go ahead and click on this and see if that changes anything here. And there you go. We see the phone call click custom event trigger. So congratulations, you've set it up. And now this event is up and running and working for you. And once you start seeing that data, you're going to see it show up here, and you'll be able to see this data in your Facebook ads conversion columns as well as of course optimizing for it. So that is what I wanted to share with you here in this video. If you guys found value in this video, I invite you to check out my website at ivanmana.com, where I give you free starter access to my online marketing blueprint course, which is about 50 plus hours of content showing you everything the A to Z of marketing online. It has 7 modules, and if you just enter your name and email, I'm going to give you guys free starter access to it. So this is what it's going to look like on the inside. You have 7 modules. This video is a topic that I cover in the Facebook ads module, which has about 10 hours of content or so, but you can go through all of these. Website building mastery, for example, you can come in here, and whatever it is that you need with online marketing, it should all be here. So you can come in here, see what's available, all of these different ways to grow your business online, whether it's website building or tracking and analytics or Facebook ads, everything you need to grow your online presence is here in this course. So that is all for this video. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next one.